since 2006, young athletes have been going to France to compete at their first international sporting competition, the Masters U in tennis. They may be aspiring professionals, future stars, or eternal amateurs, but they all have two or three things in common. They're students, they love tennis, and they came to win. States of America.
Hi, I'm Robin Anderson. I'm 20 years old. I study economics at UCLA. I'm from the US.
They came from Asia.
My name is Bai Yan, from China, and I'm studying the Renmin University, China.
They came from Europe, from Eastern Europe.
My name is Julia Valetova. I'm 19 years old. I'm studying in Russian Sport University, like sport management.
And from Western Europe, too. I'm a second-year student in sport techniques and science in France. My first year was a success. To mix study and tennis is tricky, but it's okay. To find out about the origin of this unique event, we look to the French University Sports Federation and its president, Jean-François Sautereau. This is a world university tournament with the best academic teams, including China, the United States, and France.
And it represents what's best at the moment at university level, and at the level of double excellence, excellence of mind, and excellence of body.
This year, the country club of Aix-en-Provence was hosting the events, but while the venue changes every year, the support enjoyed by the tournament is permanent. Last year for the Davis Cup, during the match between France and the United States in Monte Carlo, the entire team of the US was their top university squad. And one year, the famous Bryan brothers and John Isner played the Masters U at
Rouen l'année précédente.
The presence of experienced umpires emphasized the seriousness of the event. Among them, one very well known on the ATP and WTA circuits, Cédric Mouvier, has umpired four finals at Roland Garros. And here, he was pleasantly surprised by the blend of freshness and talent. There are no rankings, no money to win, so it really is all about the essence of the sport.
And that's important, to return to basics a little bit.
And it really is pretty fabulous to be able to combine studies at a level of study that's certainly very high with a level of tennis that's exceptional. The high standard of tennis illustrated by the presence of the best American students. In the U.S., students are the nation's best prospects, and their number one woman was here, Robin Anderson.
The competition's, like, really high. I mean, I'm really surprised. It's very different from college tennis, even. Like, I go to the college tournaments, and I see, like, the same people over and over and over again. You kind of know how they play, and you come here, and you don't know anybody. And so it's very different, yeah.
She's got so much talent. I call her a little peanut that plays like a big walnut. But she's got speed and she's savvy. Yeah, she's savvy here. And we've got great hopes for her.
With her teammates, Robin was lucky to have a very experienced coach, Greg Patton, a man who's trained leading players like Andy Roddick and Serena Williams.
Worked because a lot of our players that have played here at the Masters U have gone on to play on the ATP circuit and the WTA, and the goal is for them not only to be world-class players but to play for the U.S. and Davis Cup and Fed Cup. So this is the process.
I'm a third year, and so after my fourth year, then I'm definitely going to try to play.
For several years, the USA have been the team to beat, but this time another delegation came with ambition and some pretty useful players too. China.
The Chinese, especially their female players, are ranked among the best 150 in the world, both in singles and doubles.
So this tournament is important for China.
If the level of young Chinese women is very high, it's the same for the men. One example, 24-year-old Bai Yan. He's already tasted tennis in the top echelons.
When I was 18, I played some Davis Cup, you know, in the national team. And after I got injury, so go to school for study. And maybe after I play professional tennis again, but now I love the school for study and tennis together.
The French team have won three editions of this tournament, the first two in 2006 and 2007, and then again in 2010. But since then, the Americans have won twice, the Chinese have emerged, and the Russians are back at a higher level. So time for some French realism.
Le tirage au sort nous a pas été très favorable.
Nous jouons l'équipe de Chine qui a le poids d'équipe le meilleur.
Donc une place dans les quatre premiers serait un très bon résultat.
However, it was France who would create an upset, eliminating China after seven matches of high intensity, like the one between Bai Yan and Grégoire Jacques.
Le Chinois jouait très bien, je pouvais rien faire du tout. Et je me suis accroché, ça a tourné, d'autres personnes qui m'ont encouragé, les gens qui ne me connaissaient même pas. Donc c'est assez agréable comme sensation. Et l'équipe m'a vraiment aidé jusqu'au bout et c'était génial.
In the semi-final against the United States, the French dream was shattered. Score, 6-1. The final was the United States against Russia. The Russians won in 2008, and this time Julia, age 19, was one of the youngest in their team. She saw this tournament as a springboard, a step on the road to the top.
It's my dream to play Fed Cup also, because it's next step. I hope in 3 years. I'm a dreamer, what I want.
As it turned out, the Americans would win once again, but whatever the outcome, the key was taking part and enjoying the experience with students from other parts of the world.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,